Hello, Wearable Clinicians, this is Ali Nasseh, and after about a year of wait, the EndoSwipe is finally here. And as I mentioned before in a previous video, we've been waiting for this thing, and this is a little device that helps you do SSC, which is single stroke and clean, which is a specific motion that we have developed at Wearable Endo to be used along with the ESX or EndoSequence Express technique. So let's come back and take a look at this nifty little device and see how it can help us do what we're set out to do. So before we take a look and see how we can use the EndoSwipe, let's take a minute and answer the question of why we really need to use it. We at Wearable Endo recommend a specific motion with Nitai rotary files, which we call single stroke and clean, or SSC for short. This motion is a chip space-based motion. Now, what is a chip space-based motion and where is the chip space on the file? Well, the chip space of a rotary file is the recessed space adjacent to the cutting edge of the file where the dentinal debris collects after it's been cut in a circumferential action of the file. When Nitai or even stainless steel hand files rotate in the root canal, the cutting edge of that file removes dentin circumferentially. The dentin debris then collects in the chip space of the file during the rotary motion. I also want to define a couple of terms for you guys here. Engagement is when a rotary file begins to cut, and resistance is when the chip space of that cutting file is full. So all files begin to engage, and then very quickly they experience resistance once the chip space gets full. When resistance occurs, the file then experiences excessive torque, which makes the file stop cutting efficiently and can potentially break that file. In the past, I've used an analogy that I call the sugar bowl analogy to illustrate this point, and arrived at the conclusion that we should all be using our files the same way that we use spoons in order to maximize their efficiency and safety. So you see, when you use a spoon and fill it up, we have to empty it basically before refilling it, right? So we need to do the same thing with our file's chip space, because once the chip space gets full after any given stroke to engagement, then we need to clean it before taking another stroke, because that's the only way the file would be at its maximum efficiency. So please keep this very important point in mind. We should always keep the file's chip space clear before the file experiences resistance. Whenever you take several strokes in the root canal without cleaning the chip space, then you risk that you're creating loose debris that can block you, or it could end up being extrude out of the end of the root, causing postoperative sensitivity, or it could get packed in the dentinal walls, or also cause over-torquing of your file when it packs into the chip space and increases the chance of breaking your file. So this is why we at Wearable Endo recommended you clean the chip space after every stroke that you take to engagement using the motion that I just mentioned, which is the single stroke and clean, or SSC. And the EndoSwipe, it comes in these packages.